Now, let's now come to another area, which is pension. Mr. Onyeka, please, let's talk about this one. It's normal, you know, that after putting in so much years of service, when you leave, you come, especially when you leave at a pensionable age, you should collect pension.
That's right.
But these days, even to collect your pension, there's so much hassles you have to go through. We've seen a lot of stories, we've seen a lot of videos when pensioners go to collect what is their entitlement. And then a lot of people were complaining that this system is not even protecting them. So at the end of the day, they don't even want to leave the system. And when eventually they leave the system, nobody protects them. Because they feel that the labor unions have just folded their hands and allowed policies, like Mr. Obani actually, you know, talked about, to just run their course, whether it benefits them or not. And most times, it doesn't benefit them.
What is there is, I'm just happy for the news I heard yesterday, or this morning, that the Senate has just passed law on the pension matters. There are people that steal pension funds should be jailed for 10 years or pay 3 times the amount. That's a good development in area of pension. But the I don't think is that they should make sure this thing goes round, you know, goes round in terms of implementation, that every worker that's working anywhere, even in private organizations like mine and others, should have something set aside for them. And then put a way that it should be managed. As somebody retires at a particular time or leaves to work at old age, we'll be able to have something to live on. Because what we see here is, we see that all people walking the street who had worked, who had spent their life in the working places or other places, but when they retire, nothing to depend upon. And then the one that they had saved out of their working period had been stolen by somebody. So this is a very bad situation. It doesn't happen outside this country.
But then, you know, you're part of a union.
Yeah.
So what will you be doing to ensure that when you're anybody that belongs to, you know, the Association of Nigerian Licensed Customs Agents, when they do retire and it's time for them to collect their pension, they will collect their pension with the most minimal of stress, if there's going to be any stress at all. Because you see, the truth of the matter is, it starts with you. You understand the challenge, you understand the problem, and you know the best way, or some of the best ways to address this problem. So how is, let's say, your union, because you're here with me today, and we're having this conversation. So how will your union ensure that, in terms of making sure that people, when they retire from this, you know, from the customs agents, licensed customs agents, you know, association, they get their pension? Or whichever organization it is that they work with, as
Thank
long
so
as it
much.
Has to do with your industry.
That's what I'm talking about, the planning we need to do in terms of our getting somewhere where we'll be able to address members. Because the truth is this, most of us are unorganized. Most of us run from the portfolio of our boots, you know. They don't have such offices where they work from. So a few of us that are well organized, we are talking to the employers to put this in their place. So as if you have workers, even if it's 5 people, and you implement that in your office, in your structure, somebody at the end of a job will be part of that system and then be able to gain something. So we are talking to our members to implement that in their system. And then we are going ahead to talk to people who are not yet organized to put their places in place, put their structure in place. As few ones that work with them will be able to enjoy at the end of their retirement. These are the things we are trying to do. We are selling that idea and then gradually selling to our members, and are picking it up, and I'm sure in less no long time now they'll be able to do that to our members.
Harry, let me say a bit about this issue of pension. You know, in 2004 there was an enactment of a new law, Pension Act of 2004, which has been in existence, which makes it compulsory for every employer that has up to 5 workers to you know, set aside a certain amount of money. You know, 15%, that's 7.5 from the worker. Basic salary and that off
from
the employer. Fine, beautiful. There are many companies today that are not complying with that law. And PENCOM, which is the particular organization, you know, in charge of you know, the issue of pension in Nigeria, they were working initially when they were set up. You know, when you write a petition, and they will answer you quickly, and they will, you know, call the company to order. But now, most times, petitions are written, not being answered. They are in Abuja, and so the PFS were enacted into existence, and you know, pension fund custodians also were enacted into existence. Most of these companies, how is the monitoring going on? How are those companies complying? Some companies will only pay the workers' part and fail to remit their own portion to the PFAs. And there is no anything, no penalty whatsoever. So we are saying that, and then even the law says that you must also insure your workers. There's life insurance you're supposed to put on your, if you have up to 5 workers. Mm. You know, it's a law there. And most employers are not even, you know, complying with this. And most employees are not even aware. But it's important we need that Pension Act. You know, it's very important, 204. You know, I mean, that Obasanjo just
brought into it. That Pension Act has also, yeah. I think, there's, you know, things have overtaken it because it's been increased now to 15%.
15. No, it's 15. Now, 7.5, 7.5.
No, 15% now from the employee and 15%.
Oh, that's making
30%.
Oh, okay. That's a good one. Mm-hmm. That is, so that you can have something to look forward to, you know, when you know, exit. You know, because the old age is very important. And if you don't have anything to look forward to or something to, you know, sustain you in your old age, you're a dead man. And so it's important that we begin to ensure the compliance of this Pension Act. You mentioned issue of new act that you heard about this morning about penalty. The notion of good laws is issue of implementation. You remember the man that stole several billion that was asked to pay only 750,000 naira, you know, fine and goes scot-free. Pension money are being squandered, are being stolen by, you know, workers, I mean by government officials, and nothing happens and all that. So somebody walk, and then when you come out, you know, now start lining up. Most of them get, you know, on the road. Why traveling to come for their pension money and die on the road? Or even, you know, without any hope whatsoever. So there must be implementation of these good laws we are talking about. One thing is to make these laws. We must also ensure that we implement them. I'm happy with this issue of increase. You are saying now 30%, that is a whole lot. Hmm. So that you have to have something to look forward to when you retire from active work.
Active service.
Well. Yeah.
Now, let's look at how we are right now. I remember, way back, the level of unemployment wasn't as high as we have it now.
Right.
Is there any way that trade unions could contribute to reduce this level of unemployment that we see right now?
Yeah, the most important thing is that it's not government that's supposed to employ workers. What government does is to create what you call conducive economic environment, you know, for economic activities, you know, to be in a high tempo. But that is not forthcoming because of, it's corruption. Basic infrastructures are key. It's not government that has to create employment. If the economy is functional, if the society or the country is safe, you have inflow of, foreign investors coming in to open up factories all over the place, and then the workers themselves, I mean, people, entrepreneurs in Nigeria, will begin to succeed. Here, you do everything to succeed. The economic situation is so stifling. Even the policies of the government that is, you know, today there's one policy, tomorrow is changed. You are importing certain things now. Even while you are goods on the sea, they now change another policy, you know, making it impossible even for you to bring your goods in, different from where you now imported and all that. So these are issues. The government supposed to come in and do that, and labor union supposed to insist on creating economic atmosphere that is very conducive for economic activities. Then small scale industries, then issue of access to credit, very, very key. You people have beautiful ideas, they want to do certain things, and but they don't have money to, you know, implement all those things, because you go to bank to go and borrow, they don't even give it to you. But they go to the Dangote's of this world, go to those banks who are already established, but you that have not had any pedigree and they don't see anything you are producing, but you have beautiful idea. Whereas the reverse is the case in developed society. It's the idea that...
So this is where trade unions should come in.
Yes, come in. You know, insisting that there must be economic conducive atmosphere for operation of economic activity. It's very, very important. Access to credit, very, very key. Ensuring that government do not change their policies. And the development of infrastructure, very key. Light. Let that be light. Nigerians are not lazy. We are the most vibrant people on earth. And we want to work. Hmm. But where is the infrastructure to work and increase economic activities in the country? So these are basic issues which the labor union has rightly pointed out must come into play.
Let's quickly go. Let's look at the theme for this year's International Workers' Day. You know, in 2013, it was Let's Value Work by Providing the Jobless with Startup Capital. And the year before, it was Promote Employment by Supporting Prospective Entrepreneurs. But this year's theme is Building Enduring Peace and Unity, Panacea for Sustainable National Development. Is this theme apt?
For me, I think it's very correct. It's proper because without peace, you can't do much. But what is happening in the country is reverse of what we expected, because every facet of the economy doesn't promote peace. I went to work, you spend about 3-4 hours on the road. That has denied you the joy you would have had to get to work. Get to your office, you don't have lights, so how do you operate without power being generated from a generator or otherwise? You don't have security, some of the places you are working. So that is danger in that area. So I think as a nation, we should look at it holistically and see how where we've lost it, where we've got that mistake made, so as we can put that piece in our working places. Because you can't work where you don't have peace of mind, where you cannot access to your working place, where you spend hours going to work and coming back. Or even some of the times you are going on the road, you find that you are robbed on the road because there is no security. So these are things I think government should look at and be able to put peace in our, you know, put quiet working relationship, working atmosphere, so as people could work and enjoy their work. Mm. I have somewhere I had a factory in Anambra State, but having worked for 5 years, there was no light. We couldn't run the generator, the machines were not breaking now and then, and the government was taxing and disturbing us here and there. And I found that a growing company, and there was no way the company could grow. So if most of the countries that are located in Anambra State, some of them had closed, some of them had left that place because of kidnapping and robbing in that place. So government had to make the facilities work. They put have to put infrastructure that people that, wherever they're working, they should work with peace of mind.